Good afternoon, everybody. It's so lovely to be here. I'm sorry to the band. I've kind of bumped you into the headline slot, but I feel you're up to it. You're going to read a few poems from the Republic of Motherhood and a few from Black Country. The Spiritualist Church. I've never spoken to anyone of this, the Spiritualist Church. Its squat brick body, the mossy wall where snails congregate in worshipful hundreds on wet dust. Every day that first winter, the winter I thought would bury us both, I walked past that church in sallow light, carrying my son at my chest. My bones luminous with tiredness. I'd stand at the gates and read the inscription on the sign. Light, nature, truth. Draw it into my mouth like anaesthetic until I believed it was a message for me to ascend like a dove through the red roofs or sow myself into the sod. When the snow fell, I thought it was snowing inside my body. Milk turning to ice in my breasts, snow piling sun in the crib of my pelvis. The air burnt my lungs, and I was back on a trolley in the mid-room, frozen from the waist down. Certain he was dying, that I was letting him die, and they were cutting me open. And the sky was dolorous with sleet. I stood at the gates and dreamt of begging them to take us in, to lift my baby from my arms and lay me down in a room of shadows so I could shut my eyes at last and the hush would cover me like a burial sheet and someone gentle would rest their palms on me. Touch me with a light so staggering, I'd be opened up. My soul rising from the x-ray of my skin like a white veined moth. My body below, hollow as an instrument, humming with voices. Women in darkness, women with babies, down on their knees in smothering houses. Standing on bridges, coats loosened to wings, all of them uttering, murmuring at once, I see you, now understand that love can take this shape. A dove plummeting through white sleep night, that this is a healing, a laying on of hands. This next poem is called Bobella, and the Bobella is a really beautiful old Birmingham Black Country word for a moth. And when I was writing a poem about Bobella and talking to people about the word, it seemed that what everyone loved about it, and maybe what everyone loved about dialect words in general, was that they give us this really magical ability to conjure up other people's voices into our mouths, often the voices of people we've loved and lost. And that brought to my mind the really gorgeous myth about moths, that they carry the souls of the dead back to us. Bobella, darkling herald, see a yellow face on a waning moon and spake a name aloud to conjure the voice of one you loved and let slip through the wrinkles of death in the L light when loneliness shines through your bones like a bare bone. She'll come for you, little psyche bringing missives from the murmuring dark. She comes to all the night birds, cuckoos, thieves, the old ones and the babbies and their dimly lit wombs, the boy riding his bike up B blunt, too tender to speak of, too heart sore. But this, are you waiting? The love that lit the darkness between us has not been lost. This is another little West Midlands creature, the Birmingham Roller Pigeon. The Birmingham Roller is a really beautiful kind of tumbling pigeon, originally bred in Birmingham in the Black Country, hence its really flower name. If you've never seen a Birmingham Roller before, then you should probably just leave now and go and Google it at home. They're really remarkable birds. When they're flying, they suddenly stop mid-air and start somersaulting backwards and down. And just when you think they're going to fall out of the sky, in spectacular fashion, they swoop back up and join the rest of the birds in the cage. And as soon as I saw the roller tumbling, I just fell in love with it, because it seemed this really perfect symbol for the region, I think, in particular for its language, because it's this really ordinary, grey-looking bird, but it hides a spectacular trick under its wing. This little poem, like lots of the poems, uses some Black Country dialect, but probably the only word that's really nice to know if you don't know it already is the word donny in the last line. And donny is a lovely word for a hand, especially a little child's hand. Birmingham Roller. We spent our lives down in the blackness. Those birds brought us up to the light. Jim Shell, tumbling pigeons in the Black Country. When you're the colour of our town, concrete, steel, or your rainbow of the cut. There were streets and in your wings. There were factory chimneys, plumes on your chest. Your hearts, the china, and old girls dust in their tranquilman cabinets. Bread to dazzling. Backyards. On men whose arms were soft as feathers, just to touch you. Cradle you from egg through each death-defying tumble. Little acrobats of the terraces. We wind when we gaze at you. Jimmying the breeze. Somersaulting through the white red prayer of January. And rolling back up like a baby's yo-yo. Caught by the open donny of the clouds. More creatures, but this time horses. I've got two little sons, and when I was expecting both my boys, I spent a good long time in hospital. And there's a really extraordinary sound that you hear often on the antenatal wards, and it's the sound of babies' hearts being monitored in the womb. And if you've heard it once, you'll never forget it, because it's so fast it doesn't sound like a human heartbeat at all. It sounds like horses' hooves galloping. Horse heart. It's a stangling here. The southern hand of broken waters. Each of us private and lying in our stalls. While all night from the monitors, the sound of babies' hearts like hooves. Stumbling, stamping through our bodies into the high, wet grass of their lives. Horrendous they are. Lost now, then again in snowy fields of static. Too fast, and they're gone. Too slow, and the mind never reach us at all, but fall, heads crowned by vetch and dandelion, noses cold to the belly of earth. Oh, these hoarse nights, darkless nights, the endless running of the herd, fear a hoof upon my chest, I lie in my sweats, and beckon you on. Little horse heart, foam, let my love be your paddock, your bridle, your trough. Times called the Republic of Motherhood. Remember when my first son was born? Walking out of the house for the first time with him and slowly realising that I'd crossed the border into a strange wild land. The Republic of Motherhood. Across the border into the Republic of Motherhood and found it a queendom. A wild queendom. I handed over my clothes and took its uniform, its dressing gown and undergarments, a cardigan soft as a creature smelling of birth and milk. And I lay down in Motherhood's bed, the bed I had made, but could not sleep in, for I was called at once to work in a factory of Motherhood, the L shift. The graveyard shift. Feeding, cleaning, loving, feeding. I walked home, heart sore through pale streets, the coins of Motherhood singing in my pockets. And I sold my spindle bones in the chill, municipal baths of Motherhood, watching strands of my hair float from my fingers. Each day, I push my pram through freeze and blossom, down the wide boulevards of Motherhood, where poplars bent their branches to strike my bread. I stood with my sisters in the queues of Motherhood, the wine clinic, the supermarket, waiting for its bureaucracy to open their doors. As required, I stood beneath the flag of Motherhood and opened my mouth, although I did not know the anthem. When darkness fell, I pushed my pram home again. By lamplight, from urgent letters of complaint to the Department of Motherhood, but received no response. I grew sick and was healed in the hospitals of Motherhood with their long closed isolation wards and narrow beds watched over by a fat moon. The doctors were slender and efficient. And when I was well, they gave me my pram again, so I could stare at the daffodils in the parks of Motherhood while winds pierced my breasts like silver arrows. In snowfall, I haunted Motherhood's cemeteries, the sweet fallen beneath my feet. Our Lady of the birth trauma, Our Lady of psychosis. I wanted to speak to them, tell them I understood, but the words came out scrambled. So I knelt instead and prayed in the chapel of Motherhood, praying for that whole world fucking queendom. Its sorrow, its unbearable skinless beauty, and all the souls that were in it. I prayed and prayed until my voice was a night cry. Sunlight pixelating my face like a kaleidoscope. Come slow, so slow. Come cuckoos, come wenches in the Jack Square eve. The parish lantern is rising in a quarter to turn like a dish of cream. And the bolts are rocking. So slow, slow, slow. Come sweetheart, come lads, through the bobbing dust. Let your tears grow idle and trust yourself to the singing black cut where the osses are nuzzling. So slow, slow, slow. Come lovers, come babs. Along the towpath, now hid with black medic and clover to lay yourself in. Cowslip and yarrow wild as a bed, where the wind is moaning so slow, slow, slow. Come again, love, again, love, slower, so slow. And I'll just finish with one more poem. When I became a bird, lo, nothing could not stop me. The air feathered as a bell upon my arm, and windows as a charm, black on gold, last star at the door. Singing, they came, throstles, jenny wrens, jack swallows swinging their anchors to the clouds. My heart beat like a wing. I shed my nightdress to the drowning arms of the dark, my shoes to the sun's widening neck. Bed, I found my bones hollowing to slender pipes. I shot the blades drifting down. I spread my flight greedy arms to watch my fingers jingling like 10 hummingbirds. My feet callousing to knuckly claws, as my lips calcified to a hooked kiss. Silent, then an exaltation of larks filled the clouds, and in my mother's voice chorus, take flight, chick, go far for the winter. So I left girlhood behind me like a blue egg, stepped off from the winter ledge. How light I was, as they lifted me up from wren's nest, pulled me over the edgelands of concrete and coal. I saw my grandmother wave me up from her fold, loop the infant school and factory, let the zephyrs carry me out to the coast. Lunars I flew, battered and tuneless. The storms turned me inside out like a fury. There wasn't one small part of my body didn't bore until I felt it. At last, the rush of squalls thrilling my wing, and I knew my voice was no longer words but song, black upon black. I raised my throat to the wind, and this is what I sang.